Okay, so let me tell you about myself because I'm working as an assistant professor in Department of Computer Engineering. Then I'm AWS certified, Moodle certified teacher, then AWS accredited instructor, Moodle developer, web and mobile application developer. As well as I am AWS Cloud Ambassador 2019 cohort. So now, well, first of all, I'll introduce you about the Moodle. So what is Moodle? So Moodle is just a short form of Modular Object Oriented Dynamic Learning Environment. It's a one of the learning management system, or also it is called as course management system. And the special thing about Moodle is it is open source, it is freely available. And the Moodle is widely used. It is used in around 200 countries all over the world, and then it is most widely used LMS in the world. No other software is used as much of as the Moodle is used in the world because it's open source and it is customizable. Then, if you want to learn more about Moodle, because I'm going to tell you in short, if you want to learn more about Moodle, you can visit moodle.org. So see, how can we get Moodle? Okay, so as this is an open source project, we can download it, we can develop it, we can customize it as per our requirement. But in today's session, I'm not going to discuss about that, how we can download it, how we can install it, how we can customize it. This is not a session of Moodle customization or Moodle installation or Moodle administration. So just in short, I'll tell you what are the various ways to get you for the Moodle site or Moodle application. The first way is you search for the pre-Moodle sites, but obviously free Moodle sites comes with some limitations because nothing is free in the world. Okay, so you'll get free Moodle sites, but they are having their own limitations, and according to those limitations we have to use it. So there are two sites you can use: genomeo.com. This is one of the website which provides Moodle services free of cost, but the disadvantage of this site is there it shows so many advertisers on your page. Those advertisers will disturb you. Sometimes advertisements will be useful for you, but sometimes those advertisers will disturb you. Okay, so that is the disadvantage of genomeo.com. And again, the thing is that it is not as per the compliances. Okay, because it's hosted by a third party from United States. Okay, so that does not provide any guarantee of your application. Suppose in case tomorrow your application goes down, they will not take the guarantee of your application. So this is first way you can get free Moodle site from genomeo.com. Then the second is moodlecloud.com. Initially, okay, from last couple of months up to last couple of months, this Moodle Cloud was free for up to 50 users for all people. But now they have changed their policy, and now you'll get the free Moodle site. You can create your free Moodle site on moodlecloud.com, but this site will be valid for only 45 days. 200 users can be created in that site. Okay, you'll get near about only 200 MB data space, and you will get so many other applications in that Moodle app application, but it is valid for only 45 days. So the second very good option for you people, if you are a college administrator, if you are a college principal or a director, this is the second option for you, that is self-hosted Moodle. So it is the best solution to develop your own e-learning platform. Right now, we know that there is a big problem for us in this pandemic situation. So it is necessary for every college, every institute to develop their own e-learning platform where students can come together. Two students and faculty will come together and they will start learning together. So it is a centralized. Okay, the advantage of self-hosted Moodle is very straightforward. That is, it provides you the centralized data for compliances, like we are going, we go for MBA, NAAC, or any other accreditations. So for these accreditations, the self-hosted Moodle is very good solution. It's the best solution for that to show your e-learning platform. Okay, so again, the best the sort of the advantage of a self-hosted Moodle is, according to the UGC, you know that every faculty, it is must for every faculty to publish their own MOOC, Massive Online Open Courses, and those MOOCs you can create on Moodle and you can publish it there also. Okay, so so many things are there, so many advantages are there of Moodle, but later on we'll see that. Okay, so now let me tell you that the roles in Moodle LMS. There are different roles in Moodle LMS. So these are the roles. That is, first is administrator, who is the main in charge of Moodle LMS account, who is looking after all the activities, all the administration part of Moodle LMS. Then second is manager. So manager is like again administrator, but he will have the limited capabilities, he will have the limited roles. Then course creator, that is we teacher, and course creator or teacher will create the courses, will publish the courses, will enroll the students. Then student, where student will log in, student will enroll, can enroll their courses, they can see their study material, they can attend their classes. And the last is parent. So parent also will come online, and they can track their child's progress or their ward's progress through Moodle LMS. So these are the roles in Moodle LMS. Today we are going to discuss about course creator, teacher role only. We are not going to discuss about all these things because this is the part of Moodle development and that takes too much time. The next is teach with Moodle LMS. Okay, so how we can teach with Moodle LMS? So if you want to teach online, we want to conduct online classes through Moodle LMS. Yes, it's possible. Moodle comes with some integrations of third-party applications. Those applications are also free of cost. Those applications are also open source. One of the very good software is there, that is Big Blue Button. This is open source online conferencing system. Okay, so with this Big Blue Button, you can schedule your classes, your online classes, you can conduct your online live classes, you can chat with your students, and so many things you can do. You will get a whiteboard as well. Okay, you can create breakout rooms as well, and you can also share your screen with the students, you can share your external videos with the students as well. So Big Blue Button is very good for conducting online classes, and you can teach with the help of this application. Then the second is attendance. So if you want to mark the attendance of your students, whether you want to mark it automatically or manually, those things are available in attendance activity in Moodle LMS. Okay, so this is required for teaching with the Moodle LMS. Then share resource with Moodle LMS. So for sharing purpose, there are different resources in Moodle LMS. There are different modules of resources, like book. You can create a book activity resource. In that resource, you can, like a real world book, like our hardbound book, you can create indexes there, you can create a table of content, and you can create different pages of the books. Then file, you can share, you can upload your files and folders. Page, you can create the page of your any study material. If you want to make any create a page of your any tutorial, that you can create on this Moodle LMS. So this is very good. Okay, that you are getting these things, that is for sharing your resources on Moodle LMS. So book, file, page, and folder. Then how we can do the assessment with the Moodle LMS? Okay, we know that we can teach with the Moodle LMS, we can share our resources with the Moodle LMS, and we can also do the assessment with the Moodle LMS. So the first assessment tool in Moodle LMS is assignment, where you can post the statement, your assignment statement, assignment question. Student will write the answers, or student will create the document file in Word, Microsoft Word, and they can upload that file on the Moodle LMS. And also you can assess, you can evaluate that assignment, okay, according to their submissions, as per their submissions. The second assessment tool in Moodle LMS is quiz. You can conduct online quizzes, but the specialty of Moodle LMS quiz is that it comes with various question types. Whether you want multiple choice question, whether you want multiple answer question, whether you want essay type question, whether you want a missing word question type, blah blah. There are so many types of questions in Moodle LMS quiz. Later on we'll explore that. Then again, the right now in currently we know that there are various pedagogies in teaching learning process. So there is a very good pedagogy, that is peer learning. Okay, so if you want to use peer learning here, there is an activity, there is an activity workshop. So that workshop activity you can use for creating your peer activities, okay, peer review activities or peer learning activities, where students will come together, they will do the submission and they will evaluate, they will assess their each other's submissions. And the last assessment again is their lesson, where you can group multiple things in one lesson. Like we give the lessons to the students, where we give the notes, we give the questions according to the as per those notes. Like that, this lesson activity helps you to create your content pages, create your question pages, okay, and those you can use for the assessment. Okay, so these four activities are very useful for the assessments with Moodle LMS. Now we know that the big problem in online teaching, online learning, is the engagement of the students. Okay, because we know that we don't want just passive learning. Okay, we want active learning as well. Okay, so we know that there is a pedagogy, active and passive learning. So active and passive learning is possible with the Moodle LMS. Okay, so active learning we want here, that is with the help of gamification we can engage our students. Okay, we can create the interest amongst the students to learn things, to try things in online learning. Okay, so there are three activities in Moodle LMS, that is H5P interactive content, where you will share your video, you can upload your video, and in that video you can post or you can create in video quizzes. Okay, means whenever a student watch the video, in between that video student will get the questions, student will solve those questions. There are so many things available, later on I'll show you that. Then game activities also there, you can make your learning fun with the help of games in Moodle LMS. There is also third activity, that is quiz venture. With this quiz venture, again you can make your quizzes as a game. Okay, through games student will solve their quiz. Okay, so these are the things available with the Moodle LMS. That is, we can gamify with the Moodle LMS, gamification is possible in Moodle LMS, assessment is possible with the Moodle LMS, sharing of the resources is possible with the Moodle LMS, and teaching is also possible with the Moodle LMS. So I'll return back to the demonstration now. Okay, now we'll see the demonstration that how we can do all these things in Moodle LMS. Okay, so let me share you. Okay, so see, I'll tell you here. Okay, so I have created one of the free site on genomio.com, that is mcoefdpict2020.genomio.com. So if you want to create your own site, it's very easy to create. Okay, so let me show you that also. So if you just have to, we are down for maintenance. Okay, very very sorry. See, this is the problem of this free site, that is they will not give the guarantee to you that whether it is available for 99.99%. okay, now see, right now it is under maintenance. Okay, so That is the problem. Okay, now I have to go back to my own. Let me check this is working or not. Yeah, this is working. Okay, so yeah, so I have created MCO FDP ICT 2020.genomio.com. The process is very simple. If you want to create your site, you just have to log into open genomio.com. There it will ask you for the subdomain like this. So this subdomain you have to enter there, and you have to enter your mail ID. Only two things you have to enter there on that form, and then you have to click on create site. Okay, so within 1 or 2 minutes that site will get created by the genomio.com, and you will receive a mail like this. You will receive a username and password of your site. Okay, and with that site you can log in your Moodle site. Okay, so now I'll log in my teacher login. Okay, I'll not log in my administrator login. So santosh.nagarguje. okay, so course creator login, I have logged in with course creator account. So in this course creator, you will see here, you will see your courses, whatever the courses you have created, which are in progress, which are in future, you have scheduled it, and you have whatever you in the past you created courses, that will you will get, you will see here. Okay, so right now I have created some courses, so because of I have scheduled those courses, because of that it is showing it is in future. Okay, so how to create course? The first thing is that how to create course, because if you want to teach online, okay, how you can teach with the Moodle, because it's not a straightforward application where you will just log in and you will go with all things, not possible. There is a process in Moodle, that is whenever any course creator logged in with his account, okay, with his credentials, first he needs to create course. Okay, after creation of the course, all other things he can create, all other activities or resources he can create. So I'll go to here site administration. In site administration, okay, so whenever you want to create your course, you have to go to site administration here if you are logged in with your course teacher account, and here you will see manage courses and categories. Just click on this. Again, see, this is the problem of genomio.com. See, every time it is occupying the space here, the advertise will show here. Okay, and in some of the browser like Firefox is totally blocking this site. Firefox by default, Firefox browser is having ad blocker, and some of the times also Chrome is also blocking this site, because this site is showing too many advertisements. So see here, I have created the course categories through my admin account. Okay, through our admin account we can create the course categories. Course categories are nothing but like our departments or our classes. Like I'll create a category department of computer engineering, and under that I'll create a category like FE SET B, and under that we can create our courses. So right now I have created a category FTP ICT 2020. So I'll click on that category here, and here at the right side it shows the category FDP ICT 2020. So here it will show the button create new course. So I'll create on create new course. Okay, so for creating course, it shows one window here. One window will come here, and in this window you have to enter your course full name. Now course full name is our the name of our subject which is mentioned. So I'll enter here my course name, that is web technology. Okay, and the course short name you have to enter here, so I'll use WT. okay, after that course category will be available here. If you want to change course category, you can choose from this drop down box. Okay, then course visibility, if you want to hide this course, you can just select hide, because if it is scheduled course you can hide it. If you want to show it immediately, you just select show here. Then course start date. So when do you want to start your course, you will just use the date here. So I'll use here 17th of June from 12 o'clock 12 a.m. my course will will be started. Okay, when do you want to go end this course? So you have to specify course ended as well. So generally we have a one semester, so we should use one semester date here. So right now I'm not going to enter any end date here, but you can enter your end date here as per your choice. Then again, course ID number. Suppose if you're you know that we are having a course code in our syllabus, so just enter that course code here. Suppose my course is having 310 and 246 course code in syllabus, so I'll enter that course ID number here. Then in course summary, you can display about your course. So this course, I'll show the summary here. This course is teaching web technology concepts. Okay, and after that, if you want to show any image there, course image, okay, you can upload that course image just by clicking on this insert or edit image button. Or if you want to insert any audio or video about your course introduction or welcome, if you want to upload any welcome video, okay, welcome speech video to your students, that video also you can upload through insert or edit video. Just you need to do what here. If you are having YouTube video, you just copy paste your YouTube link here, or you can upload your video from your source URL or from your media, okay, browser repositories, and you go to your computer directories and upload it. And you can also upload audio also from this audio option. Okay, so this is useful when you want to upload any welcome video or welcome audio to your students. Then again, other things are there like record audio, then record video. You can, okay, you don't need any other recorder, video recorder, audio recorder here. It is by default is having, Moodle is having audio recorder and video recorder. Those we can use, and we can record our audios. If you want to post any audio to our student, we can record by clicking this button. Or if you want to record any video, we can just click on this video button. Okay, so this editor comes with so many options, and you can use those things here. Okay, later on I'll tell you that. Okay, but right now just remember the course summary here. You can include anything, and you can include like your learning outcomes or your course outcomes. So I'll enter here, suppose after learning this course, students will be able to, okay, first develop a simple web application. Okay, so this way you can enter your course outcomes here. Okay, that is important, we know all. So if you have a course summary file, you can directly upload here as well. Okay, so then, okay, so course summary file generally accept only three files, that is image files, GIF, JPG and PNG. So here you can upload your course image. Then course format is there. So in course format, it comes with four formats. So single activity format you can use, where it will show only single activity. You will use social format also. You can use topics format. Generally we use topics format because we go topic wise. And also if you want a weekly format, where it will show the weeks when from the starting of your course. But right now I'll use topics format here. And how many sections you want, you can enter here. By default it comes with four sections. You can increase or decrease. Okay, there are so many, up to 52 sessions you can create here. Okay, that is more than sufficient for you people. Okay, so if you want to set a hidden section, so hidden sections are shown in colors form, or hidden sections are completely invisible. If you want to hide your sections, you can do with this option. And then course layout. So in course layout, it shows all sections one page, or show one section per page. So if you want to show only one topic in one page, you can use show one section per page. Okay, so again, there are other options, that is appearance. In appearance, you can use force language if you want. If you are teaching any other subject like Marathi, Hindi, that time you can use those languages here also. Force calendar, you can use calendar, which calendar you want to force there. Number of announcement, you can restrict here. Show grade book to students, If you don't want to show grade book to students, you can select no. I'll choose here yes. Show activity reports. If you want to show activity reports to the students, okay, you can show it here. Okay, so, or if you don't want to show, you can hide it. Okay, I'll keep it no now. So see, whatever help you want, those helps are given here in the question mark button. See, I don't understand this. What is this? That is show activity reports. So that time I can do one thing, that is I just click on this, I'll get the help about this option. That is, what is it? That is, activity reports are available for each participant that show their activity in the course. Okay, so there are again other things like files and upload limits. If you want to restrict your students to upload the maximum upload size of your students, you can restrict it. The site is having maximum 100 MB. You can restrict it up to 10 KB as well. So I'll do it 20 MB now. Then completion tracking. This is very important. See, because whether students are attending your doing your course or not, or they are attempting your course or not, how can we check it? So there is a completion tracking in Moodle for the course. So you just enable, by default it is enabled. So if you don't want to track, you can choose here no as well. Okay, so there are rest of the things are there, but right now it is not important. So groups, I'll tell you groups. So if you are creating groups of your students, you can share your course with a specific group also. Okay, then role renaming. In role renaming, you can rename your course. So roles, like my role here is now teacher or course creator, so I can rename it to resource person. Okay, so if you want to like that, if you want to rename your course student a student role, I'll give it to, like, suppose participants. Okay, so this way we can rename the role also in Moodle course. Then in tags, so see, this is generally used when students are searching any course, or students are searching any course on the Google search engine. So that time these tags will help them to find this course easily. Okay, so I'll write here, suppose demo course, I'll write here FDP. Okay, so then now finally I'll go to 7 display. Okay, so I'll click on 7 display. So now the course has been created. So this is the first important step in Moodle LMS for any teacher to create a course. Now our course is created. You can see 4 topics are created. Okay, at the top it shows announcements. By default, announcement activity is created there. Now see, I am not able to put anything here. I am not able to edit anything here. So how to edit it? It's very easy. Okay, but before that, see this left navigation drawer. You can see this is a navigation drawer. In this navigation drawer, you will see your course related options, like participants. Here you will see the participants, badges. You can, so see, to engage your students, we can gamify the teaching learning process, and we'll allot some badges. Okay, we'll give some badges to the students while after completing any activity. Those things are possible also here. So badges will be displayed here. Competencies. So competencies is a big part where you can measure your learning outcomes, your course outcomes. In grades, you will see the grades of the student. Okay, you'll see the mark sheet of one mark sheet of all students, where you will see the list of students and their activity marks. Okay, and here you will see the topic names as well. Okay, later on you will see the dashboard, site home, calendar, these many options. Okay, but see, in the right side, this is a course home page, and at this course home page you can put your activities, you can put your resources. Now I want to edit this course again, so I'll do one thing here. Click on this action menu, that is gear icon, and you will see the turn editing on. So see, if you want to do any modification in your course settings, you can again go back to the edit settings. I can, and you can change the settings of your course. And if you want to edit on this course homepage, you just click turn editing on. Now after this turn editing on, now you can see, you will see the different options here, buttons here. Now I am able to edit all these things. Now see, I want to change this announcement activity, so I'll use here, I'll rename it notices. But see, you have to press enter button here whenever you edit this, okay? Don't just click anywhere else. Just after entering your activity name, just click on enter button so that it will get saved here. Okay, now see, after this I can rename the topic names. Just click on pencil icon, okay, and then enter. Suppose I'll enter here introduction to web technology. So let's consider this is my first unit or first topic. Okay, let's consider I'll use your client side technologies. Okay, so this way we can rename the existing topic name to our topic names. Okay, now after this we can do one thing. Okay, now we can go to here. Okay, add an activity, but right now I think the completion tracking, okay, it's enabled. I'll just let me check it. Completion tracking, if it is not showing in the course, yes, it is enabled. Okay, so see, now here we want to put our study material, we want to post our activities, we want to create our activities, and so on. So Moodle comes with different activities and resources. So just to add any activity or resource, you just click on add an activity or resource. So here it comes with so many activities. You can see so many activities are there. You will not get these many activities in any other software in the world. So see, these many activities are available. So first activity is here, assignment. So we'll go with the teaching first, okay, and later on we'll go with the assessments. So teaching with Moodle LMS, I told you that we can teach with Moodle LMS with the two tools, okay, Big Blue Button and Attendance. So Big Blue Button is for connecting with the students for live classes, and for marking attendance you can use attendance activity. Okay, so see, Big Blue Button is one of the open source web conferencing system which is very useful in distance education or live classes. So just you have to select this Big Blue Button whenever you want to schedule your live classes. I'll click on here add activity. Now see, it comes with again another window adding a new Big Blue Button. Okay, and here it shows instance type, whether you want room or as well as activity with recordings, or whether you want only room or activity only, or whether you want only recordings. So I want recording plus room activity. So here it asks for the virtual classroom name. So I'll give the name here, that is T Computer Engineering. Okay, so if you want to send the notifications to your students, you can send those notifications through this send notifications. Okay, so now after that, if you want to see more settings, okay, there are so more settings here. You can put the description, lecture of WT. Okay, then there are activity room settings. You want to put in a welcome message, so welcome students. I'll put here welcome students in this lecture. Okay, and there you can make the setting here, wait for moderator. Okay, students cannot join your class unless and until moderator comes there. Okay, so you can do that here also. Then again, a recording settings, recording settings you can edit because this is a free version, free Moodle, and there we cannot customize anything according to our requirements. So recording is not available right now. So participants, so right now there are no participants of this course, so I'll tell you that, okay, how we can. But see, here you can restrict your lecture to some of the participants or some of the roles. You can restrict to the role, means only managers can attend your class, only resource person can attend your class, only teacher or only guest. Okay, so you can restrict to the roles, specific role, or if you want to show your lecture to all users which are enrolled in your course. Okay, so participant list here, so all users who are enrolled here, they will become the viewer by default, and the user, the course creator, teacher will become the moderator here. Okay, so you can change the roles here also. So after that, we come to the scheduling. So how we can schedule our session? So we can open our session on 17th of June to 21. Okay, so it is 19 I'll do, and whenever when I want to close my session, so after 1 hour I'll end my session, so 15 18. Okay, so this is we can do with help of big blue button. So all other settings are there, like common module show on course page. There are so many settings available. If you want to restrict to the only some of the groups, so you can use groups as well also. Okay, so there are two again options which are very important in this Moodle, that is restrict access and activity completion. These two options you will see in every activity. In every activity you will see these two options. So restricts access will allow you to restrict access to or to apply the restrictions to your course, okay, to this activity, who can access this activity, who cannot access this activity, okay, that you can restrict with the help of restrict access here. So see, there are different restrictions. Okay, you can apply restriction based upon the date, on which date you want to make available this activity, unless and until that specified date come, student cannot access this activity. Again, grade restriction is there. Unless and until students get the specified grade, this activity will not be accessed. User profile, so unless and until student enter any value in their profile field, this activity will not be available to them. And then restriction sets, more complex logic or nested restrictions you want to apply, those you can apply in the restriction set. Okay, so see, this is what the restrict access restriction in the Moodle LMS, and the very important, that is activity completion. So see, whether your students are doing that activities or not, okay, that you can track with the help of completion tracking. Okay, so this option will help you to track the student progress. So it comes with three options: do not indicate activity completion. If you don't want to put activity completion, you leave it. Okay, you just put select this option. If you want to allow your students to mark manually this activity as completed, you can choose these options. But if you want to mark that activity when specified conditions are met, you can choose this option where it will ask for the condition. So as this is a lecture activity, it shows student must view this activity to complete it. Unless and until student attend this lecture, this activity will not be marked as a complete. Okay, and also you can set here completion date as well, but I'm not choosing right now here. You can choose it, okay, as per your requirement. So later on, tags are there, tags you can enter. So I'll use online lecture, okay, WT lecture. Okay, so these tags are available. Competences we will not discuss here. Okay, so see, this is what a single activity which we create in Moodle. There are so many options available with which you can restrict your activity. You can track the completion of this activity, because this is the major problem in online teaching, that is whether students are actually doing their work or not. Okay, they are completing their task or not. So that is possible in Moodle, and that is the specialty of Moodle. Okay, so now I'll save and display this activity. Now see, after saving this activity, it asks for the join session, but right now there are no participants in this course. Okay, so we know that we want participants means our students. Okay, so how we can add or how we can enroll students in this course? Okay, that's the major concern now, because teacher has created course, but if there are no students, we cannot do anything. So how we can add the participants in this course? So just go to this participants menu in the left navigation drawer, In this navigation drawer, you will see you are the only one participant right now here. So how to add now participants here? So there are buttons on the top and bottom as well, that is enroll users. You just click on that. This is the first option to enroll your students in your course. And here you can select users, you can search your students one by one. If you want to add single student or one or two students in your course, this option is useful for that. So suppose I want to add a student one here. Okay, so I created some dummy accounts here. So I'll just enter student, and after that I'll see the list of students, different students. I'll choose student one here. Okay, so this way I can choose so many students here. Okay, and I can enroll them here. So this is very difficult option if you want to enroll near about 50 to 60 students, because in our class there are near about 60 or 120 students. Okay, depends upon class strength. So that time this option is not useful, this enrollment option is not useful, because one by one we cannot select those many users. Okay, so there is a very good option second, that is select cohorts. So you can create cohorts, means you can create groups, a group of students. Like I have the second year students, and that time I'll create a group. In Moodle it is called also called as a cohorts. So I'll create the SE group or second year group, and in that group I'll keep my all the users. So see here, I have already created a SE group. Okay, so whenever I click on this drop down button here, it shows SE. So this SE cohort is having 20 students. Okay, I created 20 students, and I'll put them into this SE cohorts. So after that there is the option assigned role. So what role you want to assign to those students, as a participant or non-editing teacher? So I want to assign participant. So generally non-editing teacher role is used for those people who are the part of this course, who are teaching this course, but they are not the part of assessments. Okay, so that time you can use non-editing teacher role for those people. So there are so many settings also. You can start your default enrollment duration, you can start from which date, those things are available here. So now select enroll selected users and cohorts. Now I'll remove this, okay, this, because already it is a part of this SE cohort. So now I'll click on this enroll selected users and cohorts. Now it enrolled 20 users in this course, 20 students in this course. Now you can see all these students are enrolled in this course. Now the participant count including me is 21. So this way you can enroll your student. This is the one of the way to enroll your student. There are other ways also. You will say that, sir, this is very difficult for me because I don't know about cohorts, or I am not able to create the groups of students. So don't worry, we have other options also. Okay, so there are just click on, at the right side there is a gear icon, just click on that and just go to enrollment methods, or also groups are also there, but enrollment methods, click this. Okay, in this enrollment methods, Moodle allows you three types of enrollments: manual enrollment, where you can enroll the students; guest access, if you want to provide guest access to the students, okay, that is also possible here; and if you want to ask student to enroll themselves, that is self enrollment. So that is also possible in Moodle. So see, the self enrollment is very easy. Just you have to enable this option. See here, it is already disabled. This eye icon is now blocked. Just click on it. Now it gets enabled, and after that you just share your course link. So whatever the course link, so see, this is your course link. So this course link you just copy and you just paste, you just send to your students. Student will access that link and student will enroll the course. Now again the question is that anybody can enroll that course then at that time. Okay, so we have again one solution to restrict the specific students only. So just click on this setting icon in self enrollment, go there, and give the enrollment instance name. So test I'll give here, then allow existing enrollments as, allow new enrollment as. So you can set an enrollment key here. So I'll use here enrollment key test 123. See, I'll use the, this is a password for enrolling your student, so that only limited students can enroll into your course. Again, after that you can limit this enrollment, okay, for some specific duration. So if you want to make it only for 2 days, I'll use 2 days here. If you want to make it for month, hours, minutes, seconds or weeks, you can do that here also. But so this will restrict the enrollment duration to only 2 days, okay. So you can start and end date you can set here. You can do very useful. If you want to restrict the maximum enroll users count for your course, suppose my class is having 60 students, so my enrollment must be 60 for my course. So I'll use here 60. So other options are there, like after enrolling course, okay, students will receive a welcome message. So here is option, send course welcome message. So from the course contact you can send it also, means from your mail ID, from the key holder, or from the no reply address, okay, no reply address of our site. So I'll send it from course contact. So after that you can enter custom welcome message. So I'll enter here, suppose welcome students in the course of WT, okay, and then save changes. Okay, so see, I have defined the self enrollment here, so it is renamed to the test now here. Okay, now students can enroll to my course with help of this enrollment key. Now I'll tell you how we can do. I'll open the student account now. Okay, so MCOE FDP ICT 2020.genomio.com. So let me show you that how students get enrolled. So sign in, and here I'll enter the student one. Okay, now you can see student one account is now logged in here. Now he is already enrolled, sorry, he is already enrolled there because I have done the enrollment with the help of cohorts. But see, whenever student wants to enroll, he can go to site home here, okay, and after going to site home, he will see the available courses list like this, and here he will see the course name, teacher name, and here he will see the this key icon. That means this course is enabled with the self enrollment, but with the enrollment key only. You can see this way he will see the course summary here. If you set any photo, that photo will be visible here as well. So whenever after clicking on this course, now it gets access, but there it asks for him to enter enrollment key, and then he will get enrolled into that course. Now you can see the student he can see the activity, this big blue button activity for online lecture, and before this activity, okay, you can see along this activity, you can see there is a dotted square that is called as a completion tracking icon. So it is showing not completed. Unless and until student attend this lecture, this activity will not gets tracked here, which will not get completed here. Okay, now see, we'll go back to our teacher. Okay, now I told you that how we can create the course, how we can enroll the students. Okay, I hope that is clear to all people. So there are three enrollment options, remember: manual, then guest, and then third is self-enrollment. Self-enrollment without password, self-enrollment with password. Okay, so now I have created this activity. Now I have to open this activity now. So I'll open this activity. Now see, I have to start my session. My conference room is ready. So I'll click on join session. Now it opens a new window where it will launch the Big Blue Button application. Okay, so it opens here. So it asks for the whether you want to listen only or whether you want to use microphone. So this is the specialty of Big Blue Button. So here people will won't disturb you, because if they choose listen only, they cannot use microphone. Okay, so they don't need to switch off their microphone, or they don't need to mute their microphone. So here already the option is given, that is listen only the student. So while joining this session, you have to tell your student, that is you choose listen only. Okay, so if they want to ask the question, they can again go back to the microphone. Okay, so as I am a teacher, I have to choose this microphone. So I'll use microphone allow. Yes, it will first do the test of echo test. Yes, if you listen it. Yes, now you can see in this application. Okay, so this is a demo application, a demo version, which is given by the Big Blue Button. But you need to set up your own server, your own online conferencing server, if you want to use this application in your Moodle server, in your Moodle software. Like I have my own application, you can see here, which is hosted on santoshnagargoji.com. You can see I have created a subdomain bbserver.santoshnagargoji.com, and there I myself can sign in, and I can create my meetings, and I can share that meeting with the students as well. Okay, so this is the specialty of Big Blue Button. I can create the rooms, and I can start the meetings, and I can invite the students. Okay, but see, that is required if you want to integrate this software with you, because this is a demo application which comes with 40 minutes limit only. Okay, and you can your recording will also be limited there. But if you want your own application, we can develop an application and we can integrate that application with our Moodle server. So see, this is a very good software. You can see at the left side, you will see the participants here, and here you can chat with your students. Here you can show your PPT. Now see, if you want to load my PPT here, I can click on plus icon. I'll get three options here: upload a presentation, share an external video, and start poll. So other applications, so see, other online conferencing softwares are doing what? They are, if you want to share a PPT, they are doing screen sharing. But this Big Blue Button is very useful, where it will limit your bandwidth, okay, just by showing your presentation to the people. Okay, so see, if you want to present, upload my presentation, I'll go here and I'll just choose my file. Okay, that is effective teaching learning. Open, then upload. So this presentation will get uploaded here. Okay, so it is converting the file. 9 pages are there processing. Okay, now you can see, so in this window it is showing the my presentation. Now I can go forward. Okay, I can go forward. I can go to the previous slide. Okay, so this is very useful. We don't need to share our screen, whole screen, with the students, because we know that unexpectedly something, some other applications we will open there. So we don't want to show those things to the students. But so this will restrict you to only presentation. Your screen will not be visible. Your only presentation will be visible to the students. So again, this comes with the whiteboard. Okay, whiteboard tools are available there. You can see the pencil tool is there. You can use this pencil tool. Okay, you can draw anything there. Whatever you want, you can draw there. If you want any diagram, ellipse I want here, I can draw the ellipse. Okay, so these many things are available in this tool. Okay, so that you don't require any other tool. Okay, you can see here. So this will make your teaching learning more engaging and more interactive. Okay, so The very good thing about this Big Blue Button is it is having the option of multi-user whiteboard. Okay, so if you want to ask your student to write something on the whiteboard, you just turn on this multi-user whiteboard where all the participants they can write on the board. Okay, they can write their solutions on the board. Okay, so this comes with like sharing external video. You can share your external video. If you want to show any video to your student, you just click on this. You just copy and paste the URL of your video and click on share a new video. So that video will be visible to your students. So if you want to share your screen, there is a button share your screen. Just click on it. Whether you want entire screen, application window or Chrome tab, you just select it and share it there. If you want to open your camera, there is the option of sharing camera. Okay, it will ask for the allow. Okay, it will ask for start sharing. You can share your camera with the people. Okay, so this way, this Big Blue Button makes your teaching, okay, online teaching live. Okay, so you can disable also. So see, I myself conducted online written test on this Big Blue Button. Okay, I proctored my written test through this application. I ask all the students to switch on their cameras and to point them here, and I monitored their test, written test, through this application. So I use this application for many activities, for skill test activities, for assignment activities, and so on. So see, this way you can use, okay, you can put send your message through the public chat, private chat. Also other options are there. Some of the people who yesterday were asking about breakout rooms. So this application comes with the breakout rooms also, where you can restrict people. You can create a room of 40 students or 30 students or 12 students. Okay, those things are possible in this application. If you want to lock your viewers, if you don't want to allow anything to do, you can lock your viewers. If you want to save the usernames, means if you want to mark the attendance of your participants, you just click on save usernames. It will download the usernames of all the participants who have attended this session. So you can mute all users from your login. You can mute all users except presenter, or also you can clear all status icon from this as well. Okay, so this is what the Big Blue Button, and through this you can conduct your lecture, you can connect with your students. Okay, live lecture is possible through this Big Blue Button. So okay, so I'll get back to now my Moodle. So after that, after ending your lecture, after finishing your lecture, you just click on end meeting. Or if you want to record your lecture, there is the option of start recording. Your lecture will get recorded, and whenever you end your meeting, that lecture recording will be saved on the Moodle server. Okay, so I'll now end meeting. Okay, so okay, now it is going back to here. Now you can see the conference is in progress. Now it is showing the conference is ready. Okay, now this Big Blue Button, this way you can use for conducting lectures. Okay, so now about attendance. Now I want to mark the attendance. Okay, so this is generally possible in class activity, or for the online activity you can use this attendance activity as well. So I'll click on add. So give the name to the activity. So I'll give the name attendance. Description you can provide there. You can provide the grade to this activity. So I'll give the grade 10 here. Grade to pass I'll give here 4. Then I'll use here restricts access. So restrict access I'll use here unless and until. Okay, now see, I'll apply the restriction here by using activity completion. So I'll click on activity completion. Now it will show which activity I want to use for restriction. So I'll choose T computer engineering online lecture activity, and here I choose must be mark complete, must not be mark complete, must be complete with pass grade, but that activity is not having any pass grade. So I'll use here must be mark complete. It is must be complete with pass grade. I'll use because it is already automatically marked as complete. So see, these instructions will be applicable, and after that I'll use student activity as complete when conditions are met. Student must receive a grade to complete this activity. Okay, and then 7 display. It is asking for must be mark complete. Okay, that is not having any grade. So see, 7 display. Okay. Now attendance activity is created. Now in this attendance activity, you can add the session. You can add the session. So I'll add the session from this time 14 to 15. Okay. So the very good thing is that here I can put my topic which I covered in this lecture, so introduction to WT. Okay. And then I can create a calendar event for this session also. If you have multiple sessions, you can repeat this activity. Okay, you don't need to create sessions again and again. If you have a timetable and you know that on every Monday your lecture, or every Tuesday or Wednesday you are having your lectures, you just click on this repeat the session above as follows, and you choose your days of the lecture. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, so on. And repeat until, okay, so we'll repeat every week. Okay, and it will repeat until whatever date you will specify here, like suppose September we'll have the semester. At the end of semester, the ending of semester, that date you can specify here. Then after that, for the automatic attendance with student, we want to allow student to mark the attendance, so we can choose this option, allow students to record own attendance. So automatic marking here, set yes, we can mark the attendance automatically. So automatically select highest status available. Okay, so how if student is available for the most of the time, for high time, then only that time this attendance will get marked. Okay, and there is a very good thing in Moodle LMS, that is you can restrict from the IP addresses also. So prevent student sharing IP addresses, you can select yes, so that student cannot share their IP addresses with the other students, and they cannot do the proxies. Okay, those things are available here, or specified time in minutes to release IP. These are all things are available here. Okay, and after that you can click on add. So see, this way, sorry, this repeat I have used. Okay, use no now here and add. So see, the session has been created. But there is another activity. So Genomio is not having the activity, attendance activity that I have tried. There is another attendance activity in Moodle as well, that plugin we need to install, where we have the other options to mark the student attendance through QR code as well. Means we will show the QR code, student will scan the QR code, and their attendance will get marked as well. So see, this way you can here you can mark the attendance. You'll get the student names, present, absent, late, exempted. You can mark their attendance. Suppose I'll mark like this. Okay. And then save attendance. So this is manual attendance. Already we can set the automatic attendance also. Okay. So you'll get the reports in report tab. You'll get the report of your student attendance. You can export the student attendance. Okay, here you can select whatever fields you want, what fields you want to include, what fields you don't want to include, in which format you want to download it, in Excel, Open Office or text format. Those all things are available here. States you can modify, like there are now different states like present, late and executed. Those statuses you can modify, and you can modify their marks as well. Okay, so for how many available for minutes, that available minutes you can enter. All those things are available here. You can use those here. Temporary users are there, but that is not useful right now. Okay, but see, This way, the attendance activity can be used while teaching your course, while teaching your lecture, while taking your lecture. Okay, after taking your lecture, you can mark the attendance by using this attendance activity. Now you can see, unless and until student attend this lecture, okay, attend this live lecture, he cannot access this attendance activity. So see, automatically the attendance will be marked here. Whenever student completes this activity, this activity will get enabled, and his attendance will be marked automatically as well. Okay, so see, this is a specialty of Moodle, that so many restrictions we can apply here. We can make our students bind to our course, we can make our students more engaging for our course. So see, this is for teaching with the Moodle LMS. I told you that how we can teach, we can take the online classes with the help of Big Blue Button, we can mark the attendance with the help of attendance activity in Moodle. Now we'll go with the next, that is how we can share the resource material with the students, because that is very important for us. So the very easy thing here in Moodle, that is we can drag and drop anything here on this course page. If you want to share your files, like your PPTs, your PDF notes, lecture notes, your videos, your audios, blah 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 blah, okay, whatever files you want to share here, source codes, anything, text files, those files you just drag and drop here, it will get uploaded here. So see, I'll try to upload any one file here, okay, so that I can show you that how we can. Okay, now see, I have a file, okay, I have a file, a text file I have. So I'll do one thing here, I'll use that file here, I'll just drag and drop it here. See, that file gets uploaded here. This is a text file. I'll try to upload any other files, like I'll use document file now here. Okay, so I'll go to any one document file here. So yeah, this PDF I can upload here. Okay, so this way you can upload any file on this course page, course home page, that will get shared with the students automatically. It's already participants are there, students are enrolled as a participant, they can view this activity, this resource. Now see, if I click on this file, it will get downloaded. Suppose if I want to embed this file in this course homepage, I have to change the settings here. I'll go to the setting, and in setting, I'll click on appearance. In appearance, I need to use embed, so that this file will get embedded in your web page, in your application. Now again, we can restrict it. Again, we can use the activity completion. Now see here, I'll use show activity as complete when the conditions are met, and student must view this activity to complete it. And again, I'll use restrict activity. I'll go activity completion, unless and until student access this file, okay, must be marked complete. Okay, so unless and until student open this file, view this file, they cannot open this PDF as well. So save. Now you can see this PDF file is embedded in my this application. There is no need to go to any new application, okay, no need to go to any new window, okay, these all things will be in the same application. Okay, so you can see again on the course home page, you can see here now the restriction is applied here, not available unless the activity gift is marked complete. Okay, so anyhow, students has to open this file, they have to read the content of this file, and they unless and until they cannot access this next file or next resource of our subject, of our course. Okay, so this is about the resources. So we can share the files, okay, also we can directly drag and drop folders here. Okay, if you have any folder, you just drag and drop that folder. Or the second way here is that you can create click on add an activity or resource there at the bottom. resources section you will see, and in this resources section you will see file for uploading your file. To create folder, you will find the folder here, folder activity here, or you have the page also. So I'll choose here folder now. Okay, so folder activity you can choose here. So suppose I want to share any sample codes of any application, I'll use your sample codes, or if you want to share any examples with the students, you can choose that. Okay, so if you want to put anything here in this folder, you choose here upload file, choose file. Okay, so I'll go there. Okay, so I'll use here, suppose if you want to choose photo, you can use it, or if you want to upload PDF file, you can use it. So in this folder I can upload files, so the students can open that folder and they can access the files. Wait for time, it is completing 75%, 82%. Okay, so it is, file is getting uploaded here. Yeah, okay, so see, file is uploaded here. The same way you can apply restrict access, activity completion. Okay, if you want to allow your students to mark this activity as completed, you can set that here also, and then save and display. So see, this will show folder like this, and in that folder it will show the files, so many files, so many folders you can create here. And if student want to download this folder, they can just click on download folder, they'll get the folder, complete folder of your sample course. So see, this is one of the way again to share your study material. Again, suppose I want to create a book here. Okay, like a book, I told you that book is one of the activity that you can use for sharing your resources with the student. So just click on book activity. So this book will allow you to create a real world book here. Okay, so book, like book is having an index, and in that inside that book there are different pages. Okay, so you can create that here. So I'll give here suppose lecture notes. Okay, after that, what type of appearance I want. So I want chapter formatting with numbers or bullets or indented, so I'll use numbers here. So style of navigation, I'll use here table of content. If I want images or text, I'll use here table of content only. Okay, so rest of the thing, you know that, restrict access and activity completion. So in, students can manually mark as completed. So now save and display. Now it is asking for the chapter. So chapter title, so I'll enter here suppose introduction to WT, then content I'll use web technology something, I'll enter something here. Okay, so this way you can type whatever notes you want, you can type it there. Okay, so after that you can put some tags. So I'll put some tags here, introduction. Okay, and then so here, like a book, okay, if you want to put any images, you can just click on insert, browse repositories, upload file. Okay, so I'll put some images here, like suppose this image I will upload here. Okay, and upload this file. Okay, so the description not necessary, you can resize it. So I'll resize it to 200 by 200, then save image. So like this you can create the book pages here, and then save changes. So see, see, book we can create like this. So you can add more chapters to this book activity. Now we'll go back to our course homepage. So see, I told you that you can share the resources. And then sharing resources is very with the help of files, with the help of folders, with the help of books and pages as well. So you can create page activity, and on that page activity, whatever you want to put, that you can create. Okay. So this is about the sharing the resources with the students. Now, the next thing is assessment. Now, for assessment, Moodle comes with so many things like assignment. This assignment activity is there where you can ask your student to submit their files, their work. Okay. So they can submit their written files, they can submit their document files. Okay. So just click on assignment. In assignment, I'll write, suppose here, assignment number one. Okay. After that, I'll put one question, like suppose write a short note on WT. Okay. For 10 marks, I'll give 10 marks here. Okay. So after that, whatever things additional, like you want to allow submission from this date to this date, due date, cutoff date, remind me, grade by date, all these things, availabilities are there. You can understand that. Okay, now submission types are there: online text and file submission. So if you want to want online text from the student, you can enable online text. If you want file submission from the students, you enable file submission. Okay, so how many maximum number of files what you want, you just select here. Okay, and after that, the maximum upload limit, you can restrict the accepted file types also. Okay, so I want PDF file here, so I'll use PDF only here. So there are so many other settings, like submission settings are there, feedback types are there. Okay, that is not required now. So grade, so if we are having 10 marks, so grade, then grade to pass 4, then blind marking, no. Okay, direct grading is set. Okay, and rest of the things, you know. So after that, save and display. Now this way, student will see in their account, student will see this page, and they'll get a button, add submission. Their student will upload, their files, and you will see those files here in the grade. So see, now for the assessment, you will see this type of window where you will see the student name and his submission. You'll get the submission here in PDF file. PDF file will get loaded here, and after that, there are so many things available here, like you have the sticky notes, you have the markers, diagrams are there. Okay, markers, stamps are there. So suppose I want to annotate this file with the right and wrong marks. I have the right mark here, I can put it here, I can put some grade here. Suppose I put 6 grade here, I want to put any comments here, I can put those comments here, and then after that, I can save it and I can notify the students. So save and show next. Okay, so this way you can create the submission activity, assignment activity, where your students will do the submissions and you will assess their submissions. So that is about assignment activity. Now the next assessment activity is quiz. Okay, so quiz activity I will show you here. So in quiz activity, I'll give a name to this. Suppose I want to conduct MCQ test 1, so I'll use MCQ test 1. Then I can set the timing here. So open date and close date you can use here. Time limit I can set here 20 minutes suppose. Okay, so after that I can set grade. So in grade, how much grades, pass grade, suppose I am conducting 10 marks test, so the grade to pass is 4. So how many attempts I want to restrict students, that is on I want only one attempts to be solved by the students, so I'll choose here 1. So I want to show every question on the same page, one page, or I want to show 2 questions on one page. So that setting I can do through the layout. Okay, then very important, that is review options. In review options, While attempting the quiz, I want to hide the correct answer. I want to hide the right answer. See, I don't want that. Okay, so I'll show the marks then, but I want to hide the whether the answer is correct or not. Okay, or I want to hide the marks. I can do those things as well. Okay, so these settings are available in review options. And rest of the things, there is extra restrictions on attempt. So if you want to make your quiz password protected, you can go to require password, and there you can write the password, you can enter the password. So rest of the things are, we know that. Okay, now click on save and display. So your activity will get created here. Now there is an option that is edit quiz, through which you can add your questions. So see, you can go here, you can add from the question from by adding a single question. If you have a question bank created, you can add questions from the question bank, or if you want to choose a random question from the question bank, that option is also available here. So right now I'll choose a new question. So see, now you will see that there are so many question types available in Moodle: multiple choice, true false, matching, short answer, numerical, blah 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 blah, so many are available there. So I'll choose multiple choice and add. So here I'll enter the question name. So I'll enter the question name here, suppose who is our PM. Okay, the same I will copy here. Now the mathematics people, they're having the doubt that how we can write the equations. So, or chemistry people, physics people, don't worry, you have the equation editor here. Just go to the equation editor. See, here you will see, just click on this arrow down button, down arrow, and here you will see the calculator button, which is called as equation editor. Just click on this, you'll get so many equations, okay, icons. Those you can choose, or if you have a LaTeX code, you just write that LaTeX code here and put that in your, just click on save equation, this will display it here. Okay, so mathematics people, remember the equation editor. So after that, I want to set the default mark 1 here. You can change it. If you want to show any general feedback after attempting this question, that you can type here. If you want, whether you want one answer or multiple answer, you can choose it here. Number the choices you want, how do you want, you can choose it here. Now option 1, I'll choose here, I'll write here Narendra Modi, and now this is correct, so I'll choose it, I'll make it 100%. Okay, and after that I'll write another option, Rahul Gandhi, so this is wrong, so I'm keeping it none. Okay, so this way you can enter other choices and you can go to save changes. Now this will show the question like this, where you can preview this question by clicking on this magnifier icon. Now you can see and you can try it. Okay, so this is one of the way, okay, to create the questions and to add the questions in the MCQ test. There is other options as well, you can see. There is other option, just you have to go to this gear icon, click on gear icon, and here is the menu, question bank. This question bank, just click on that question bank, because we all know that we don't want to add one by one question. We want to add bulk questions. So those bulk questions are possible here. Choose category, your MCQ test one. Now here in import, just go to import, and Moodle comes with so many formats, import formats and export formats. I can format, Blackboard format, and so many. So I'm not going to explain all these formats, but see, I can format and GIF format is easy to understand. So I'll tell you I can format. So I have the file of I can format, which is very easy to understand. I'll show you that I can format. See, this is I can format. You need to follow, you need to type your question. Okay, after that in the next line you need to type your option in capital letter. See, capital letter should be there, must be there, dot, space, and your option. Like this you type your four options, and then you need to specify your answer like this: answer in capital letter, then colon, and give space, and your correct option. So this way You can type, okay, this is the second way again. That is, you can use ABCD options like this. You can, instead of this dot, you can use this bracket symbol. But everything should be in capital letter. Your answer should be in capital letter. So this format should be followed while you, whenever you want to upload bulk questions, bulk MCQs in the in your quiz. So you need to import this file here in the by choosing this icon format. Then here you will choose this the file. You will click on import. Questions will get imported, and that will be shown in the question bank. Okay, there is another format, that is GIFT format. So I'll just show you the format of GIFT. See, GIFT format is like this. So because there are some limitations of icon format, those limitations are overcome in GIFT format. So see, this is initially it is difficult to understand, but I'll just try to tell you. Okay, so there are various question types in Moodle. Those question types are covered in icon format. Okay, so later on I'll post the videos of all these things. Okay, so this way you can import and export questions in your question bank. Okay, so we'll go back to course homepage. So I told you that we can do the assessment with the help of assignment activity. We can do the assessment with the MCQ test. Okay, with the time limitation, I'm not able to cover many more things. But later on, surely I'll post the videos of other activities. So just I'll take a couple of minutes, just 1 minute I'll take, and I'll explain that what other things are available in the Moodle. So you have the chat feature, you have the certificate feature, you have the feedback. You can also take the feedback through Moodle. You can also you can create the forums, discussion forums. So I told you that gamification. So gamification is possible with the help of game. So in Moodle, you'll get the games like this: crossword, cryptex, hangman, hidden picture, millionaire, snake and ladders, sudoku. For mathematics people, just note down this software. GeoGebra is one of the tool for creating your mathematical activities. Then glossary activities there, the interactive content activities there, that is H5P, where you can embed the videos and you can embed the questions in that video. So like this, lesson activities there, quiz venture is there for gamification of the quiz, workshop is there for peer activity, peer review. So there's so many things are available there, and with these activities and resources, I think you don't require to use any other application for the teaching learning process with Moodle LMS. Okay, so I think this is sufficient. Okay, the videos of other things, other activities, I'll share with you people. So I hope you understood